Russia is planning to modify its Su-30SM fighter jet to carry the KH-32 air-to-surface missile. Reports indicate that the KH-32 became operational in 2016 and is primarily carried by the Tu-22M3 bomber. Izvestia reported that the KH-32 could be carried on the centerline hardpoint under the fuselage of the Su-30SM going forward. Viewers may note that, in general, aircraft can carry their heaviest weapons or fuel tanks under the fuselage. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how Russia plans to turn Su-30SM into carrier killer with KH-32 supersonic missile. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. Total U.S. military expenditure is over one-third of the world military expenditure, and it's more than 10 times that of Russia's spendings. Russia cannot possibly compete with the U.S. platform by platform, weapon by weapon. For example, the U.S. has more than 10 aircraft carriers, whereas Russia has only one, and that too is in very bad shape. Russia's only aircraft carrier, Admiral Kuznetsov, may no longer be actually operational again. The aircraft carrier has suffered back-to-back accidents in the last 2 years and is out of service for a long time. An assessment by the Russian Navy's Northern Fleet estimates the damage of 95 billion rubles, over 1.5 billion US dollars. The repair cost is almost as much as the current value of the warship. In this situation, Russia is developing asymmetric weapons to counter the US, especially the American supercarriers. Arming Sukhoi Su-30SM with KH-32 missiles is a step in this direction. The Sukhoi Su-30 is a twin-engine, two-seat, super-maneuverable fighter aircraft developed in the Soviet Union by Russia's Sukhoi Aviation Corporation. It's a multi-role fighter for all-weather, air-to-air, and air-to-surface deep interdiction missions. The Su-30, developed by Sukhoi, is considered to be one of the most successful Russian defense export programs in the past 2 decades. It's in service with about 12 nations, including China, Vietnam, Malaysia, Algeria, and Venezuela. The Su-30 is the backbone of the Indian Air Force, which operates around 272 Su-30 MKI jets, a unique version specifically designed for India. MKI, meaning Modernized Commercial Indian in English, is jointly developed with Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, or HAL. It's the first Su-30 family member to feature thrust vectoring control, TVC, and canards. Su-30SM is a specialized version of the thrust vectoring Su-30MKI for the Russian Air Force. Produced by the Irkut Corporation and has a NATO reporting name, Flanker H. The Su-30SM is considered a 4-plus generation fighter jet. The aircraft has been upgraded according to Russian military requirements for radar, radio communication systems, friend or foe identification system, ejection seats, weapons, and other aircraft systems. It's equipped with the NO-11M BARS radar with a maximum detection range of 400 kilometers or about 250 miles, search range 200 kilometers or 125 miles using a phased array antenna. It also has frontal horizon fins and steerable thrusters for super maneuverability, as well as with wide-angle HUD. The aircraft can be used to gain air supremacy, as well as for targeting adversary on the ground using a wide range of weapons, including air-to-air, air-to-surface, and guided and unguided bombs, with a total weapons weight of 8,000 kilograms, or around 17,630 pounds. To ensure operations at major distances from airfields, the ability of in-flight refueling, IFR, is included. KH-32 is a Russian supersonic air-launched cruise missile developed by the MKB Raduga from the KH-22. The missile was accepted to service in 2016 as armament for the Tu-22M3M bombers. The Tu-22M3M is able to carry three of these missiles. It weighs close to 5,800 kilograms, or 12,787 pounds, is 12 meters long, with a 1-meter diameter and a 3-meter wingspan. It can be armed with a 500 kilogram, or around 1,102-pound conventional warhead, or a nuclear warhead. It has a max speed of Mach 4.5 and a range of around 1,000 kilometers, or 620 miles. It uses inertial guidance followed by terminal active radar homing. KH-32 is intended to target U.S. carrier battle groups from long ranges. The excellent range means that Su-30SM will be able to launch the missile from a standoff distance. U.S. carrier defense includes destroyers and cruisers equipped with Aegis combat system, armed with Standard Missile 6 missiles. The Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense System is designed by the United States Department of Defense, Missile Defense Agency, to protect against short and intermediate-range ballistic missiles. Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense is devised to intercept ballistic missiles post-boost phase and prior to re-entry. It enables these warships to shoot down enemy ballistic missiles by expanding the Aegis combat system with the addition of the AN/SPY-1 radar and standard missiles. Aegis BMD-equipped vessels can transmit their target detection information to other systems, and if needed, engage potential threats using SM-2, SM-3, or SM-6 missiles. The heart of the Aegis systems on board these warships is the AN/SPY-1D radar. It's an advanced, automatic, detect-and-track, multifunctional phased array radar. This high-powered, 4-megawatt radar is able to perform search, track, and missile guidance functions simultaneously with a capability of over 100 targets. Standard Missile 6, or SM-6, has been deployed by the U.S. Navy to counter different kinds of threats. It was primarily designed for extended-range anti-air warfare purposes, providing capability against fixed and rotary wing aircraft, unmanned aerial vehicles, anti-ship cruise missiles in flight, both over sea and land, and terminal ballistic missile defense. The missile uses the airframe of the earlier SM-2ER Block 4 missile and some targeting elements from AIM-120C AMRAAM. It can discriminate targets using its dual-mode seeker, with the semi-active seeker relying on a ship-based illuminator to highlight the target, and the active seeker having the missile itself send out an electromagnetic signal. SM-6 has a maximum speed of Mach 3.5 and has a 140-pound or 64-kilogram blast fragmentation warhead, but KH-32 is thought to possess several means to penetrate carrier defense. Firstly, KH-32 flies to a target with a ceiling of about 40 kilometers or 25 miles, which is 6 kilometers or 3.7 miles higher than SM-6 missiles. Secondly, the KH-32, on the final stage, attacks the target in a steep dive, which makes it hard to track with radars. Thirdly, the multi-frequency radar in KH-32 has excellent resistance to electronic warfare, such as spot jamming. KH-32 could play a tactically critical role for Russia when it comes to taking on U.S. supercarriers. Missile defense is one of the most technologically challenging quests. It's like hitting a bullet with another bullet. When a missile moves in an unpredictable path, with a supersonic speed, it becomes difficult to intercept. American Carrier Strike Group will be in a very precarious position if they have to face multiple Su-30SM launching KH-32 from different directions and altitudes. Also, the fact that a single hit could cripple or completely destroy a warship makes it a very dangerous proposition for the U.S. military. It's to be noted here that the missile and the aircraft are a fraction of the cost of a supercarrier carrying a large number of aircraft. So even if one goes through after several attempts and losses, it's still a good bet for Russia.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.